Recurrent respiratory papillomatosis is a viral disease of the vocal cords and of the airway caused by the low-risk HPV virus type 6 or 11. And HPV stands for human papillomavirus, which is a family of viruses that is actually very, very common in the population. In fact, most of the population at some point in their life has been exposed to it. But despite a huge number of people being exposed to the virus, only a small number of people don't successfully clear the virus by their immune system, and they end up with a persistent infection. Recurrent respiratory papillomatosis, or laryngeal papillomatosis, because the two terms are synonymous, most often presents in the vocal cords. So the main symptom that people experience is hoarseness or a change in their voice. And this can be subtle, but tends to get worse over time. And then when their voice change is profound enough, they tend to seek attention. We diagnose the disease in the vocal cords by a scope that goes either in the nose or in the mouth, which can visualize in very high definition the vocal cords on the screen in the office, and we're able to review the video with the patients and show them where exactly the papillomas are occurring on the vocal cords and how this explains the symptoms of their voice. If the disease is severe enough, and in rare cases, it can actually spread into the trachea or the lungs, where then it can cause breathing symptoms as well. Surgery has been the mainstay of treatment for RRP ever since the 19th century, and there's been many different surgical instruments that have been used to remove papilloma. Currently, the instrument that I believe is the most effective is the KTP laser, which is a special green light laser that's absorbed by the very dense vasculature of the papilloma. So it's very effective at removing the papilloma while protecting the underlying tissue underneath, which is essential to produce our voice. So the idea behind surgery is to remove only the papilloma and leave the underlying vocal cord entirely intact, and that's how we get the best possible voice results. The overall strategy in my hands for patients with papilloma is to remove the papilloma in the operating room, to completely clear away the disease, and if possible then, if the disease comes back, to remove the remaining papilloma in the office, because the same laser that we use in the operating room we have available to treat in the office. And so when we can treat in the office, we avoid all the side effects and the complications that go along with general anesthesia. And it's a great treatment option for patients who have really, up to this point, only been able to be treated in the operating room. The medical options for papillomatosis have been very limited. There's been many attempts over the years to try to develop adjuvant agents that could slow the growth of papilloma. As I always tell patients, when the disease has recurrent in its name, you unfortunately have some idea of what you're up against. So there's been many attempts to try to use either injections or agents to try to slow the growth of papilloma. I think it's only recently that we've become aware that there is a medication that actually could potentially be a real game changer for the treatment of papillomatosis. And that's Avastin, or bevacizumab is the generic name of it, a medication that targets the growth of blood vessels. And when this injection is performed in conjunction with the laser surgery, we've seen really good results in terms of preventing the rapid regrowth of papilloma. And in addition to that, for the patients who have the most severe forms of papilloma, that are affecting their vocal cords and recurs rapidly even after weeks after surgery, or it's spread to the trachea or it's spread to the lungs, there's essentially no good surgical options for these patients. But in the past year or two, we've started successfully treating some of these patients with systemic Avastin, or the IV infusions, that have actually had almost miraculous effects in terms of reducing the papilloma and stretching out the time that it requires between surgeries, and really had amazing results in terms of improving the voice and breathing for some of these most severely affected patients. At the Johns Hopkins Voice Center, we have a number of unique treatment options for patients with RRP. The first is that we have all the modern laser technology that we need to be able to treat patients in the operating room and in the office with the KTP laser. For many patients who have been used to having surgeries in the operating room, It's a massive improvement in quality of life to be able to have their disease treated in the office and avoid the side effects of general anesthesia. In addition to that, we have really pioneered the use of Avastin, or bevacizumab, the generic name, both for office-based injections as well as for the use of systemic Avastin for the most severe cases of papillomatosis. We have a great working relationship with our medical oncology team who helps us administer the medication. We've been able to get approval through insurance companies for what essentially amounts to an experimental treatment, but it's for the most severe cases and the patients in the most dire need, and we've seen some really great results for patients who have had no good treatment options. As a center, we really specialize in the treatment of this disorder, and I see many patients from across the country and the world who have this to seek care here at Johns Hopkins, and we really pride ourselves in our ability to offer cutting-edge treatment.